Christmas time. You know, it's my job to beat down overplayed songs, and no songs are more overplayed than the entire genre of Christmas music. Better watch out. No genre is more stagnant, more overdone, more stranglingly oppressive. When you're a kid, jingle bells may be fun and wonderful, but by the time you become an adult, you will have heard every Christmas song so many times that even the name Mannheim Steamroller should get your skin crawling. And what's worse is that there's nothing new to replace it. Except for Mariah's All I Want for Christmas Is You, there hasn't been a new song to worm its way into the Christmas classics canon in the past 25 years. We desperately need some new songs. But we're gonna fix that. And so I present to you, the man who is gonna bring this tired, moribund genre back to life. We last checked in with Justin Bieber over a year and a half ago, and even at that distant date, he was already the poster child for all that was bad in popular music, as well as the scapegoat for everything that had gone wrong in America in the past 4 years, and possibly also history's greatest monster. Anti-Bieber hysteria was at a level not seen since the Red Scare. Poorly spelled insults toward the poor kid flooded the internet. The backlash had become a phenomenon far worse than Bieber himself could ever be. That was the peak in the tide of Bieber hatred, which has since been on a downward slide, and as far as I'm concerned, that's a good thing, because I remember this same thing happening during the boy band wars of the late 90s, and trust me, there were no winners in that conflict. Whether you liked them, or whether you hated them, you were probably an idiot. So I'm happy to see this kind of thing dialed back. It got very old, very quick. But I completely understand where the hatred is coming from. Justin Bieber is quite possibly the least likable, most uncharismatic performer to get popular since the heyday of Vanilla Ice. I despise this little shit well before any of you did, and I'll likely do it long after he's been forgotten. Let me show you what you're missing. Paradise. I'm sure it's not entirely his fault, and it's hard to tell his managers that they're doing something wrong when they're clearly selling a lot of records, but I still do not understand the decision to give this poor kid these songs where he has to act like he thinks he's hot shit when he clearly can't back it up. That's basically all it boils down to. Bieber's balls haven't dropped, which is why he's so eminently hateable when he's trying to project confidence, and it's also why Baby is both his best and his best known song, because it puts him in a vulnerable position instead of treating him like he's this hot young stud. You know you love me. Although he's still pushing it. There's just no getting around the fact that he sounds like a kid, like not even a teenager, a child, singing about love and other topics, which, like, I mean, his songs aren't exactly sophisticated or adult by any stretch, but they're still about things that sound well beyond his reach. The kid has the sexual charisma of a Tickle Me Elmo. Still, he has done the world a favor and largely not troubled me or any of his other haters since the last time I reviewed him. It's like after the hysteria died down, Bieber and the world made this agreement that he's gonna do his thing and the rest of the world can do theirs, because I've barely heard a thing from him since then. Despite having as many fans as he ever did and being one of the best-selling music acts around, he's been surprisingly easy to avoid, making his one-off Christmas single Mistletoe, which reached number 11 for a week in November, qualify as one of his biggest ever hits. Now, my policy is to avoid Christmas music if possible, so I certainly didn't plan on dealing with this, but I started to actually get interested in Bieber's Christmas album after I stumbled across his rendition of Little Drummer Boy. Now, keep in mind that Little Drummer Boy is quite possibly the dreariest, most unmodernizable Christmas song of all time, 12 Days of Christmas excepted, and I wasn't expecting much. But I was actually really impressed. Not because of Bieber, but because it features Busta Rhymes. Busta Rhymes of all people. And he gets on the mic and he busts some rhymes. Well, hell, I might have to give this a chance. Of course, Bieber's performance is awful because, surprise, trying to inject soul into Pa-rum-pa-bum-pum makes you sound like a dipshit. But I did happen to notice one very encouraging thing about Bieber's performance.
Little baby, yeah, yeah, yeah. I farm a poor boy to
Bieber's voice is finally changing. Praise baby Jesus, it's a Christmas miracle. No longer will I have to hear intense love songs performed in Bieber's vomit-inducing castrato. I won't solve all my problems with the little bastard, but you know what? It's a good freaking start. So you know what? This might at least be something worth seeking out. Now, Bieber's new song is called Mistletoe, and who knows, it could turn out to be listenable. Or it could turn out to be some god-awful preteen kids bop crap like he always sings. Hope for the best, expect the worst, I always say. Let's give it a listen.
It's the most beautiful time of the year. Lights fill the streets, spreading so much cheer. I should be playing in the winter snow, but I'ma be under the mistletoe. I don't wanna miss out on the holiday, but I can't stop staring at your face. I should be playing in the winter snow, but I'ma be under the mistletoe.
This is a white guy with acoustic guitar song. This is a white guy with acoustic guitar song! Justin Bieber, Justin freaking Bieber, world's whitest of white boys, doing an acoustic guitar song. Oh, thank you, Bieber! Two of my least favorite things in music combined. Looks like I got my Christmas present early. Oh my god, this was a possibility I was not prepared for. What the hell is this? This is just Jason Mraz's I'm Yours.
Well, you done me and you bet I felt it.
Justin Bieber made a Christmas song that rips off one of the worst songs of the last 10 years. It's even got the same freaking chords. Oh my. Our young Bieber is growing up into a bro. I weep for this child's future.
I should be chillin' with my folks, I know. But I'ma be under the mistletoe.
Oh, this is really kinda gross. Okay. In it, Bieber appears to be singing about the Christmas things that he's not going to do because he's going to be under the mistletoe with you. Well, give Bieber this, he knows his audience. Even NSYNC wasn't this shameless with their Christmas single. They were just like, Christmas, yay! They just liked Christmas. Bieber, meanwhile, takes the holiday and uses it as an excuse to sell Kissy Kiss fantasies to his girly girl fanbase. This is not really a Christmas song, it's a love song awkwardly filled with clumsy Christmas references. And yeah, I know there are plenty of songs about being in love on Christmas, but All I Want for Christmas Is You, Blue Christmas, Please Come Home for Christmas, these are all about the sense of belonging and togetherness that Christmas is supposed to be about. Mistletoe, on the other hand, is about making out with Justin Bieber. And if you don't want to make out with Justin Bieber, this song is absolutely nothing for you. I guess this goes out to all the Christmas shawties out there. I think the entire anti-Bieber movement can be traced back to his use of that one awful word. No matter how old he gets, he'll still always be far too white and too Canadian to use that word properly. Not that I'm sure that there's a good way to use it. But more than that, I never wanted to hear the word used in the context of Christmas. Christmas.
Chestnuts roasting on an open fire.
Shoddy.
Shoddy.
Christmas.
Have a holly jolly Christmas. It's the best time of the year.
Shoddy.
Shoddy.
No, they don't match.
Word on the street, Santa's coming at night. Reindeer's flying through the sky so high. I should be making a list, I know.
Okay, goddammit. How old is the narrator of this song supposed to be? This is like the first Bieber song I've ever heard that attempts to deal with the unavoidable fact that he sounds like a first grader. But I'm not sure that was a better plan than just ignoring it. Like, is it a good thing that we're constantly reminded that he should be out writing to Santa and other age-appropriate things? You know what? Maybe it's just me, but when he talks about the Christmassy things he won't be doing when he's busy getting to first base, does he seem honestly kind of sad that he's not getting to do all these things? I mean, he's trying to sound excited about being this girl, but he just sounds resigned, like he got dragged to grandma's for the holidays. Should be out playing in the snow. Freaking girlfriend making me go kiss her.
I should be chillin' with my folks, I know.
Yeah, you should. You should be doing all those things. And now that I'm thinking about it, you should also be singing about these things, Bieber. I get that mistletoe and love are important parts of Christmas, but this just doesn't sound Christmassy in any way. It's like he wrote a Christmas song about how he failed to make a Christmas song.
The wise men followed a star, the way I follow my heart.
Wow, we are stretching the Christmas theme as hard as we possibly can. No, just an experiment. Let's stretch it even harder. Your kiss makes me feel alive, just like Frosty the Snowman came alive when we put on his magical hat. This is awful.
Everyone's gathering around the fire, chestnuts roasting like a hot July.
Yes, no imagery more thoroughly conveys the atmosphere of the holiday season like the words hot July. Hell, I don't even have to bring up that one line of bad writing. The problem permeates the entire freaking song. I mean, yeah, I hear the sleigh bells jingling in the background, but otherwise, musically, this completely fails to communicate the idea of winter. Christmas songs are supposed to have a certain sound to them, right?
It's the most wonderful time of the year.
Yeah, like that. But mistletoe just does not sound right. Who the hell associates this kind of fratty white reggae with the holidays? The only Christmas song I can think of that sounds like that is Mele Kalikimaka, and that's about Christmas in Hawaii. And judging by the video, that's not what they were going for. Seriously, you can't just throw some bells on a song and call it a Christmas carol. But of course it had to sound like a Jack Johnson type bro ballad, because that's the most droolingly simple of all possible musical genres. After all, recording something that actually sounded like anything else would have taken time and effort. And if they had any of that to expend, they wouldn't be making a Christmas album. I mean, Christmas albums, with rare exceptions, are quickie cash-ins designed to restock bank accounts and fulfill contractual obligations. But this goes the extra mile to sound cheap and thoughtless. This blows. This just isn't about Christmas in any real way. It's about exploiting the underdeveloped dreams of hormonal tween girls. That's not what Christmas is about. Christmas is about family. It's about togetherness. It's about giving. It's about peace on earth and goodwill towards men, goddammit! Sorry. No. If I had one wish this Christmas, it wouldn't be about anything like this. It would be that we all get together and love one another and enjoy the true spirit of Christmas. And most of all, I would wish that Justin Bieber would wipe that stupid smirk off his face. I'm Todd in the Shadows saying God bless us, everyone, except Justin Bieber. Good night.
I saw mommy kissing Santa Claus.
Hey, I'm gonna be at MAGFest. MAGFest, 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 MAGFest.
When you're alone and life is making you lonely, you can always go to MAGFest. If you've got worries, go and do something nerdy at MAGFest. At MAGFest.
It'll be here. It'll be at this time. Be there. See me. Please. Thank you.